वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनाभवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावतीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विदधाति पूर्वं ये वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तवमहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो। मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपी अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्कृत्यपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं तदेवाहन्नमत्वन्यदिति मे निश्चिता मतिः। There is an objection to raised by the Purvapakshi, an objection raised to the Jnana, which is mentioned here earlier. So Pramanas and Prama. So for each Prama, there is a valid Pramana. Valid means of knowledge. Pramana itself means valid means of knowledge. And as an example, it was said that pratyaksha pramam prati asadharana karanani chakshuradi indriyani. So pratyaksha prama is due to pratyaksha pramana. Now prama happens to be chaitanya in siddhanta. So there was an objection raised as to siddhante pramanama chaitanyam eva vedantamate. Then that being nitya, chaitanyam nityam, then how can it be Indriya Janya? How can you have Pramana, which leads to Prama, which is Chaitanya, which is Nitya? So there the answer was given, Chaitanyasya Pramatvapadika Vrittirapi Prama Ityuchyate. So Prama is to be known in context. Definitely Prama is Chaitanya, but Vritti is also called as Prama. And Vritti is Agantuka. Vritti comes and goes. Now, how does Vritti come about? It comes about due to Pramana. Therefore, Chaitanya is Nitya, meaning Chaitanya Rupa Prama is Nitya. However, Vritti Rupa Prama is not Nitya. It is Janya and it is based on Pramana. And Tasya Vritti he Indriyam Karanam. For that kind of a Pratyaksha Prama, Vritti Rupa Pratyaksha Prama, Indriya is Asadharana Karana and thereby Karana. Now, we'll look at the four different types of Chaitanyas which were mentioned. Pramatra Chaitanyam. Pramatra Chaitanyam is defined as Deha Madhya Vritti Antakkaranena Avachinnam Chaitanyam Pramatra Chaitanyam Ityuchyate. So Deha Madhya, Madhyavarti, that which is there within the Deha, Avachinna, in the Deha, that kind of a Sukshma, Sukshma Sharira within the Stula Sharira. Sukshma Sharira is limited in the Stula Sharira, and Stula Sharira, Sukshma Sharira, which is within the Stula Sharira, that Sukshma Sharira or Antakkarana, Tena Antakkarana Avachinnam Chaitanyam, Yat, Tat Pramatra Chaitanyam Ityuchyate. So Antakkarana Avachinna, basically we see in this definition, Antakkarana Avachinna Chaitanya is Pramatra Chaitanya. Where is it? It is in the Stula Deha. So that is Pramata. That is called as Pramata. Pramata is Pramatra Chaitanyam. Pramana Chaitanyam. What is Pramana Chaitanyam? Idameva Antakkaranam Chakshuradi Indriya Dvara Bahirnirgatya Ghatadi Vishaya Desha Paryantam Dirghi Bhava Rupa Parinama Prapnoti. So सो इदमेव अंतकरणं प्राप्नोति इट अटेन्स व्हाट इट डज इट अटेन दीर्घी भाव रूप परिणाम दैट इज वृत्ति इट एक्सटेंड्स टुवर्ड्स द ऑब्जेक्ट सो द अंतकरण विच एक्सटेंड्स टुवर्ड्स द ऑब्जेक्ट चक्षुरादि इंद्रिय द्वारा थ्रू द इंद्रिय गोलकास एंड the indriyas which are sitting in the indriya golakas going out they drag the antakarana also that dirghi bhava roopa parinama is called as vritti bahir nirgatya ghataadi vishe desha paryantam till the object it reaches till the object going out through the indriyas tataha ghataadi visheyaihi samsrujya ghataadi tadvishaya karana cha parinamate And then it takes the ghatakara vritti ityadi antakarana modifies in the shape of the object in keeping with the object not necessarily shape in the form in keeping with the form of the object if it is shabda shabdakara which is called as vritti vyapti yatha and the example we have seen earlier I had mentioned this yatha tadakadokam lost sound has everyone lost sound
No, it's working fine.
Okay. Was some issue at your end? So, yatha tadakodakam pranali dvara bahir nirgatya kulyatmana parinamam prapya kedaran pravishya tattat chatushkona chatushkonaadi roopa kedarakaram bhavati. So, you have seen the example of the water going out to the fields. The fields are, you know, having different shapes and they have borders so kedara kedaran pravishya having entered the water tadakodakam the water from the well goes out and then so here in the field through a channel pranali dvara bahir nirgatya kulyatmana parinamam prapya takes the form of the water takes the form of the field tat tat chatushkonaadi roopa kedarakaram bhavati similarly the antakarana vritti also takes the form of the field in the example the field in the exemplified the vishaya how going through the channel in the exemplified through the indriyas tatha eva antakaranam api chakshuraadi indriya छिद्र द्वारा बहिर्निर्गत्य विषय रूप केदारं प्राप्य विषयाकारं भवति सो टेक्स दि दिस वी हैव सीन अर्लियर सो नो पॉइंट इन स्पेंडिंग मच टाइम देयर तत्र देह देशम आरभ्य घटादि विषय देश पर्यन्तं यः अंतकरणस्य दीर्घी भाव रूप परिणामः स एव वृत्ति ज्ञानम् इत्युच्यते सो व्हाट इज दैट वृत्ति ज्ञान और वृत्ति रूप प्रमा विच इज इंद्रिय जन्य फॉर विच इंद्रिय इज द प्रमाण It is this dirghi bhava roopa parinamah, the extension of the antakarana from within to without, till the within to outside, till the vishaya, that dirghi bhava, becoming extended, that is called as vritti jnanam. Because that itself undergoes change. And takes the akara of the vishaya, vishayakara. Jnana, virti jnana roopo yo antakkarana parinama sa pramanam iti kathyate. And virti jnana roopo ya antakkarana parinama. That is the pramana. It is called as pramanam. Virti jnana roopo ya antakkarana parinama. When you say sahaya virti jnanam. So dirghi bhava roopa parinama is vritti jnanam and vritti jnana roopaha antakkarana parinamaha is pramanam. Thereby you get prama that vritti jnana indriya janna vritti jnana that is pramana. Tena avachinnam chaitanyam pramana chaitanyam ityabhidhiyate. And what is the pramana chaitanya? The Chaitanya, which is avachinna by this pramana, is pramana chaitanyam. Now this leads to prama or pramiti. What is pramiti chaitanyam? Pramiti chaitanyam athva prama chaitanyam. Mentioned earlier, prama and pramiti are interchangeable words. Kedaram pravishya yatha jalam kedara samakaram bhavati तथा घटादि विषयं प्राप्य अंतकरण वृत्तिरपि घटादि विषये समानाकारतां भजते. जस्ट लाइक दी जला वाटर टेक्स दी शेप ऑफ दी फील्ड, सिमिलरली घटादि विषयं प्राप्य अंतकरण वृत्तिरपि घटादि विषये समानाकारतां भजते. टेक्स दी घटाकार पटाकार मठाकार, all these kind of vrittis, शब्दाकार, रूपाकार, all types of vrittis, रूप, आकार are taken by the vritti, अंतकरण वृत्ति. तादृश विषय समानाकारतया अवच्छिन्न चैतन्यं प्रमा चैतन्यं इत्युच्यते. तादृश विषय समानाकारतया अवच्छिन्न चैतन्यं, that चैतन्य which is in keeping with the विषयाकार. सो तादृश विषय समानाकारतया अवच्छिन्न चैतन्यं प्रमा चैतन्यं इत्युच्यते. बिकॉज वृत्ति हैज टेकन दी घटाकार, चैतन्य विल आल्सो मिमिक दैट एज दो, इज ऑल एज दो. चैतन्य चेंजिंग इज ऑल एज दो, अदर्स कैन बी टेकन एज लिटरल. अंतकरण कैन अंडरगो मॉडिफिकेशन, चैतन्य कैनॉट अंडरगो एनी मॉडिफिकेशन, बट स्टिल being the basis of the antakarana which is changing into vishayakara vritti, that chaitanya can also be said to be in that form. Just like in my sharira I feel that I extend up to the nails, similarly the chaitanya in the vishayakara also, Chaitanya will also take the Vishayakara as though. So that is called as Prama Chaitanyam or Pramiti Chaitanyam. What is Prameya Chaitanyam? Athava Vishaya Chaitanyam. Jnana Vishayi Bhuta Ghatadyavachinna Chaitanyam Vishaya Chaitanyam. The Vishaya, Ghatadi Vishayas being there, the Chaitanya which is limited by the Vishaya, that is called as Prameya Chaitanyam. So just like you have four divisions, you have the Chaitanya divisions also. Just like you say Triputi and an additional fourth we saw yesterday, last part. Huh? Similarly, Chaitanya in keeping with these, or Chaitanya identified with these, are called as those particular Chaitanyas. They take the Visheshana, the Chaitanyas, so to say, not plural, but then still, like Ghatakasha, one Ghatakasha, two Kumbhakasha, all these are Namabhedas. Similarly, there are Visheshana and Namabhedas. There may, it may not be a Visheshana per se, it may be an Upadhi in some cases, but still, the Chaitanya, even if it is not changing, Nama Matra Bheda is there. Etha Sarvaha Vedartha Sampradaya with Acharya Krita Paribhashaha. So these are technical names given by Vedanta Sampradaya Krita. So Sampradaya with Acharya Krita. So those who are trained in the Sampradaya, they have made these technical names so that we can understand what is the prakriya. To understand the prakriya, the naming is given. Sanya. It's a paribhashika sanya. It's a technical jargon used there. Now we have to define what are these pramata ityadi. Pramata lakshanam. Who is a pramata? Avacheda vadaritya pramatru sakshinoho swarupam विशेषण लक्षण उपाधि लक्षण. सो अवच्छेदवाद वादा प्रक्रिया वेर दी जीवा इज एक्सप्लेन्ड बाय अवच्छेदा बाय लिमिटेशंस. द एग्जांपल इज घटाकाश एंड मठाकाश महाकाश. सो विद दोज एग्जांपल्स भगवान भामतीकारा एक्सप्लेन्स इट. सो अवच्छेदवाद इज प्रसिद्ध इन भामती कम्स इन भाष्य ऑल्सो. भगवान भाष्यकर हैज गिवन दिस. नाउ अवच्छेदवाद रीत्या प्रमात्र साक्षिणो स्वरूपम. हु इज अ प्रमाता, हु इज अ साक्षी. देन प्रमाता हैज अंतकरण एज विशेषण. सो विशेषण लक्षण इज ऑल्सो टू बी नोन. यू कैन नॉट जस्ट से इट्स अ विशेषण. What is a Visheshana? Generally known, but still that is also defined. And when you say Sakshi, Sakshi is Sakshi has Antakarana, not as a Visheshana, as an Upadhi. We have seen earlier. Now, Upadhi Rakshana also has to be mentioned. So translation is adjunct in English. People understand the word adjunct as much as they understand Upadhi. Meaning, we don't understand really what is this upadhi or adjunct. Just another word. So you use one word to explain the other. You don't know the other word also. Then you use the first word to explain the other word. That's a catch 22. But some kind of a definition should be given if the word themselves are not literal at times. Avachheda. वाद रीत्या अंतकरण विशिष्ट चैतन्य प्रमाता. सो प्रमात्र लक्षण किम. प्रमाता इज अंतकरण विशिष्ट चैतन्य. मीनिंग अंतकरण हैज विशेषण सॉरी चैतन्य हैज विशेषण ऑफ अंतकरण. व्हेन इट डज देन दैट एंटिटी बिकम्स प्रमाता. सैव कर्ता भोक्ता च एंड दैट प्रमाता ज्ञाता मंता. प्रमाता इज ज्ञाता मंता Shrota, all the kartrutva bhoktrutva is there for this pramata. Antakrana upahita chaitanyam sakshi. But sakshi is also chaitanya but does not have antakrana as visheshana but as upadhi. So upahita chaitanya meaning chaitanya having the upadhi of antakkarana. Ekameva antakkaranam pramatuhu visheshanatvena sakshinah upadhitvena cha bhavati. It's the same antakkarana. Just like it's the same chaitanya also. Chaitanya is same, antakkarana is same for one jiva. Chaitanya is same across jivas but antakkarana is same for one jiva. Antakkarana is different for another jiva whereas chaitanya is same. But that Chaitanya when associated with the Antakkarana, one becomes Jiva one, Pramata one, and associated with Antakkarana two becomes Jiva two, Pramatru two, Pramata two. So therefore, Kartrutva Bhoktrutva Bhedas being there, Karta is different, Bhokta is, Karta Bhokta one is different, Karta Bhokta two is different and so on. The Chaitanya is same. That Sakshi Chaitanya we have seen with the differences in Antakkarana, there is a naming to the Chaitanya Sakshi. But Sakshi Chaitanya, even if you show them to be multiple, cannot be different from Brahma. You have seen this earlier. This was a question raised by Tattva Drishti. Tattva Drishti or Sampurva Pakshi. I don't remember whether it was before Tattva Drishti got into the picture or earlier. Earlier also it was there. This discussion was there as to who is the Sakshi and who is this Jiva, so to say, Pramata. So, Ekameva Antakkaranam Pramatuhu Visheshanatvena. For the Pramatu, for the Pramata, Antakkarana, same Antakkarana is Visheshana, whereas for Sakshi, the Antakkarana is Upadhi. Now, Visheshana and Upadhi words have been used in the definition of Pramata and Sakshi. So, we understand Pramata and Sakshi through the words Visheshana and Upadhi. But what is the Visheshana and Upadhi words? What do they mean? Visheshana may be simpler, but still it's technical because grammatically what is an adjective? And it may not be exactly so the way we understand. So, that is clarified by sadhu visheshana lakshanam. What is the definition of visheshana? Vastu swarupe yasya pravesho asti. Pravesha means what? Tippanakara says karena saha sambandha. Pravesha means karena saha sambandha. Vastu swarupe yasya pravesha asti. Sambandha asti. In the vastu swarupa, that which has sambandha. If you are looking at any substance, anything, we'll take substance because substantial, that which is substantial, which is a substance, that has an adjective. So you have visheshya, which has a visheshana. You have a noun or a substantive. The substantive has an adjective. So vastu swarupa is for the substantive, unto the substantive, yasya pravesha sambandha asti, that which connects, that which has a connect sambandha, tadrusham vyavartakam, vastu visheshanam ityuchyate. Tadrusham vyavartakam vastu visheshanam ityuchyate. So that which segments or distinguishes it from others. Vyavartakam means that which will distinguish. So something that will distinguish the vastu, which connects to the vastu, is called as visheshana. So this is the explanation. Explanation, or it can be considered a definition also in a very generic language. But then technically the definition is through the Nayayika's jargon. So that is given here. Karyanyute. Karyanvayitve sati. Karya anvayitve sati. Karyanvayitve sati. Vyavartakatve sati. Vidyamanattvam visheshanasya lakshanam. Visheshana is defined as what? That which has karya anvayitvam. Meaning that which has anvaya vidyakarya. That is called a sambandha. Earlier in a simple language it was said as praveshaha. Pravesha means what? Karyeshu sambandha. Karye sambandha. That is anvaya. Another way to say is sambandha is anvaya. There is an anvaya. When you make a Sanskrit anvaya, we show which word connects to which word. And when we connect the words, the padarthas, how they are connected, is understood. Sambandha is understood. So karyanvayitve sati vyavartakatve sati, meaning that which has karya anvaya, and while having anvaya vidhi karya, sambandha vidhi karya, also has vyavartakattvam. Vyavartakattvam means what? It has the capacity to distinguish between similar vastus, between similar substances. Similar but not same. So in one aspect, similarity means in one aspect they are same. In some other aspect they are different. So what is the differentiating aspect? That will be shown by the visheshana. That means the visheshana has vyavartakattvam. And having karyanvayitvam, karya anvayitvam and vyavartakattvam, it also has, it is vidyamanatvam. Vidyamanatvam, it also has vidyamanatvam, it is present. So that which is present along with the thing connects to the thing and distinguishes the thing is called as visheshana. This is a clear lakshana. Now what is vyavartakatvam? Padarthantarebhyo vivichya vastu swarupa avedakam yat tat vyavartakam ityuchyate. What is that property, distinguishing property? That is padarthantarebhya vivichya, having differentiated from other padarthas, other substances, vastu swarupa avedakam yat, that which reveals the vastu, the nature of the vastu, nature of the substantive, that is called as vyavartakam. Vyavartaka means differentiator. That has Vyavartakattvam as a property. So, Vyavartakam meaning the differentiator is that which is the revealer of the nature of the thing, substantive, having differentiated it from other things, other padarthas. Itarebhyo bhinnataya yad budhyate tad vyavartyam ityuchyate. So, if you studied Vyakrana, Paniniya Vyakrana, you will know what is Aka. So, Aka is Nul Pratyanta. Aka is Kartari. It's a Krasanta which uses Nul Pratya. Your Anaka replaces Nul with Nul means Vu. Nakara and Lakara are it letters. So, Vu survives. In Vu also, Vu is an it letter really. Or maybe Uccharana Arche. So, what remains is Vu there. So, Yoho. So, the sutra says Yoho. So, we can take Vu itself. So, Vu remains. Vu is replaced by Aka. Last time I had mentioned U is replaced by Ana. So, Lyut U is replaced by Ana. Nul Vu is replaced by Aka. So, you get Vyavartaka. Forget what is there here. All that is there. Vriddhatu. Ityadi. So, that is Kartarim. Therefore, this Vyavartanam means differentiation. So, Vyavartakam is Kartari of that. Meaning, Karta of Vyavartana Kriya. Meaning, the differentiator. Whereas, on the other hand, you have Vyavartya. Ya Pratya is used. It can be Yat or it can be Nyat. So, these are the Pratyas. Again, Krut Pratyas. But here, it is Karmani. Karmani, Yat. Nyat, these pratyas are there. Content is ya, which can also mean fit to be differentiated, but karmani, general sense is karmani. So, tad vyavartyam, what is vyavartyam? It is the karma of the kriya of differentiation, meaning it is a differentiated. So, vyavartaka is the differentiator, vyavartyam is the differentiated. So, itarebhyo bhinnataya yad budhyate. Here, padarthantarebhyo vivichya vastu swarupa vedakam yad tat vyavartakam ityuchyate, the differentiator. And then, from whichever padarthantarebhyo, itarebhyo padarthebhyo. From other padarthas, bhinnataya, as different, whatever is revealed or known, budhyate. Tad vyavartyam, that which is known as separate from others, due to what? Due to this vyavartaka, who? The differentiator, the revealer of differentiation, and the revealed difference, differentiated, revealed difference with the difference, the differentiated, that differentiated is called as vyavartyam. So, in the example, nilo ghataha, nilaha ghataha. There is a dark pot. So, Neela really means dark, but Rudi Artha is blue. So, we'll take blue. Blue pot. Blue is easier to understand than, you know, brownish. It is actually brownish dark tinge. But Neela really means dark. We'll take it whatever color, blue. So, Neelaha Ghataha. We'll call it Neela itself. You can interpret any which way. So, Neelaha is the Visheshana. Ghata is the substantive. It is the Visheshya. So, Ityatra Ghatasya Neelavarnam Visheshanam. Neelavarna. Neela is Varna. It is a color. It is a Visheshana. Yataha Neelavarnam Neelaghatasvarupe Pravishtam Sat Rakta Peeta Shvetadi Varna Vishishta Ghatebhya Vyavartya Prathagimam Neelaghatam Bodhayati. So, what does Neelaha do in Neelaghata? The word Neelaha. Yataha Neelavarnam. The Neela is Neelavarna, the blue color. Once you understand, Padapadarthayo Nitya Sambandha. So, when you hear the word blue, the blue color comes to mind. If you don't know blue color, if you don't know Neelaha, what is Neelaha, then there is no possibility of the word revealing anything. Once you understand the word and its meaning are connected. Once the meaning is understood, then it comes to mind when you hear the word. there by neelo ghataha, when it is mentioned, then neelaha reveals a padartha. It is connected to this ghata padartha, so it has sambandha. Anvaya is there, and not only is the anvaya there, vyavartakattvam is there. What is the vyavartakattvam? Neelaha, the blue differentiates from other colors. If you are talking about a ghata, then neela will differentiate the ghata as the blue pot, neela from the rakta pataha, rakta ghataha, shweta ghataha, pita ghataha. Whether you talk about red, yellow or white pots, definitely the blue pot is different. So neela is a visheshana. How so? Yataha neela varnam neela ghata swarupe pravishtam sat. Pravishtam and pravesha we have seen is sambandha. So having sambandha with the ghata, rakta pita shvetadi varna vishishta ghatebhyaha vyavartya, having differentiated from the various colored pots, prathagimam neela ghatam bodhayati, it differentiates. Having differentiated it, it makes the blue pot known, a different entity. Tasmat neelavarnam vyavartakam visheshanancha. Therefore, neelavarna is the differentiator of the pots and it is also the adjective. Ghatastu parichedyaha. Ghata is parichedya or vyavartyaha or visheshyaha, visheshyam. So the ghata is parichedyaha. Again, ya pratyaya is used, karmani ya. And karmani, for karmani vyutpatti, ya pratyaya has been used and it is the differentiated. So ghata is the differentiated. Yataha pitaadi varna vishishta ghataadibhya vivichya ayam neela ghataha budhyate. So this blue pot is revealed having differentiated from the other colored pots. Therefore it is a differentiated. The pot is differentiated. It happens to be blue. That is the differentiating factor. Yastu vivichya budhyate padarthaha sai parichedyaha vyavartyaha visheshyam iti chochyate. So that padartha which is differentiated, substantive which is differentiated, or I should not say substantive because that is being defined. So that entity which is differentiated and having differentiated, it is made known through the adjective really, which is the differentiator, that entity is called a parichedyaha, differentiated vyavartyaha. These are all words to mean the same thing, visheshyamiti uchyate. They don't mean the same thing literally. It can mean, you know, parichedyaha means limited, vyavartyaha can mean differentiated, visheshyam means a substantive. But these are all interchangeable words in the context, in this context. Now here it may be a little tricky to understand, so you have to see this. The dandi is the visheshana purushaha. So dandahasya asti iti dandi, kasa purushaha. So there is a man who is carrying a danda. So he has a danda, he has a stick. Actually stick means, say, it's not a stick. Dandi purusha is a sannyasi really. Sannyasi, tridandi, there are different types of sannyasis. So sannyasi is dandi. So not generally, dandi means a sannyasi. It's not anyone by vyutpatti. Yogikartha, it can be anyone who is carrying a danda. But when you say dandi purusha, generally it means a sannyasi. In any case, either meanings are fine. One who has a danda is a purushaha. That purusha is being talked about. Not one who has a danda is a purusha. The purusha who has a danda is called as dandi. So dandi purusha. There are many purushas. One of them is a dandi. So one who is carrying a danda is differentiated from the others. So dandi is a visheshana. Actually visheshana is what? Danda is the differentiator. So danda is the visheshana. Dandi is the visheshana in the pada. But danda is the visheshana in the padartha. Because dandi has a nitya sambandha with this artha. The artha is one who has danda. Therefore, danda is the differentiator. Ityadu opi dandadikam purushasya visheshanam. So, danda is the visheshana. In the padartha, danda is the visheshana. In the padas, dandi is the visheshana. Ittham pramatu antakkaranam visheshanam bhavati. And similarly, in the exemplified in our context, antakkarana is the visheshana for the pramata. Tasya pramata swarupe praveshat. Why? Because of pravesha sambandha with the pramata swarupah. So for the antakkarana connects to the pramata swarupa. Otherwise he will not be a pramata at all. Only with identification there is pramatrutvam, kartrutvam, bhoktrutvam comes about. Tatha prameya chaitanyad vyavartya pramatra swarupasya bodhakatvad antakkaranam vyavartakam cha bhavati. And antakkarana is not only a visheshana, it is also a vyavartaka, differentiator. Why? Because prameya chaitanyad vyavartya, having differentiated from the object. So you see subject object, it's a better way to look at it. Subject and object division is there in the same chaitanya. There is only one chaitanya, but there is a subject object division. How is the subject known? Subject is known by the antakkarana as the visheshana. So this antakkarana is a visheshana which differentiates from the object there outside. Prameya chaitanya vyavartya. Having differentiated from the object consciousness, there is the revealed chaitanya pramatru swarupasya bodhakatvad. The subject consciousness is revealed. Therefore, the antakkarana, which is the differentiator, differentiating factor, therefore it is called as vyavartakam also. What is upadhi now? Upadhi lakshanam, definition of upadhi. Jastu vastu swarupe antarenayo pravesham vyavartako bhavati. Sa upadhi tyuchyate. Yahatu vastu swarupe antarena pravesham. Pravesham antarena eva. Without having any sambandha, anvaya. Pravesha means sambandha, which means anvaya. Or sambandha is a simpler word to understand. Without the sambandha unto the vastu swarupa. It has nothing to do with the vastu swarupa. Swarupa is what? Which is there all the time. The very nature of consciousness is what it is. So vastu swarupe pravesham antarena eva vyavartaka bhavati. Yaha, that which is a differentiator, all right, but it is not really differentiating the nature. It has no connection with the nature of a thing, substance, or any entity. Entity is a better word, it can go with sentient as well as insentient. So that which is having no connection, real connection with the entity, but still is able to differentiate, that is called as upadhi. Very beautiful definition. So if it does not drive home, adjunct upadhi, it means when we say it is an upadhi, it means it has no direct connection to the entity. It has no direct connection with the entity. Just like you see in the flower, the crystal kept on the flower, red flower, although the crystal is clear, still it appears to be red. If there is another crystal next to it, which has no influence of the flower's redness, that will appear as white. There are many crystals, but this fellow appears to be red because of being present on the flower. The flower's redness has no connection with the crystal at all, but still it can differentiate that red crystal from the others. The redness is not its visheshana. It is a vyavartaka, but it is not a visheshana. It is just the upadhi to differentiate, used to differentiate, but it is having no sambandha with the crystal at all. That is an upadhi. And technically, what is it? Karya ananvayitve sati vyavartakatve sati vidyamanatvam upadhi lakshanam. So other two factors are common, so I'll not discuss them. Differentiate, that which is a differentiator, meaning has the property of differentiation, that existing entity which does not connect with the karya is called as upadhi, is the definition of upadhi. Nayayikamate karna shashkulya avachinnam sorry karna shashkulya avachinnam navashrotram. The space navaha is called as shrotrendriya. Shrotrendriya, the organ of hearing, sense organ of hearing, is defined by Nayayika that was karna shashkuli avachinnam. Karna shashkulya avachinnam, there is a golaka, there is a shape of the ear. There is space within. The space does not have a connection with the ear. The space is within the ear, but the ear, like we say, ghata akasha, the akasha is there. Ghata has no sambandha with the akasha. Similarly, the ear, the Nayayika says the ear is there. The space within the ear is different from the space outside. What is the differentiating factor? Differentiating factor is the ear. The space is in my ear. So it is that Shrotrendriya. Indriya is that space within which will modify according to the sound. That is called as Shrotra. And there Karna Shashkuli does not have any connection. The Golaka, Karna Golaka, does not have any connection with the Nava space, but still it is a differentiator. So it is a Vyavartaka. Vyavartaka, but not a Visheshana. Tatra Karna Golakam Shrotrasya Upadhir Bhavati. Thereby Karna Golaka is the Upadhi of Shrotrendriya. Karna Golakam Shrotrendriya Swarupe Pravesham Antarena Eva Bahya Bhutakashat Vivichya Shrotrendriyam Bodhayati. It reveals the Shrotrendriya, the Karna Golaka, without having any connection with the Shrotrendriya Swarupa itself. But still it differentiates and reveals the Shrotrendriya. Without connecting with the Shrotrendriya Akasha Navaha, it reveals the Shrotrendriya by differentiating. Therefore, it is a Upadhi. Tasmat Karna Golakam Vyavartakam Bhavati. It is an Upadhi which is called a Vyavartaka also. Ghatakasha Prastha Parimita Ghatakasha Prastha Parimita. I'll look this up. I'll come back to this. We'll continue here. It's already past 7. I have some other work also. So we'll continue. We'll continue with this. I wanted to finish this, but it's quite long. We'll stop here. Sukham Nityam Suprakasham Vyapakam Namarupi Adhishtanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddhir Ketanam Aparam Sarva Vedanta Vidyam Pratyak Paramah Tadeva Annamatva Nishchitamatihi. Is there any questions? Okay, I'll see you in the next part, huh? Hopefully in time.
Hari Om.
Hari Om.